Mr. Andrews reckons I'll be reading the newspaper next week.
Well, that is good news. Next thing we hear, you'll be lecturing at university.
Nah, doesn't pay enough.
Don't kid yourself, Baxter. Even if you do learn to read and write, which I doubt, you'll never get a job.
I will, sir. A good one.
Like what?
Anything I like. I have to spend the rest of my life making myself feel better than other people like you.
I'm warning you, Baxter.
You warn me all you like. I'll be out in 2 weeks. I'm getting my parole.
Oh, yes. We were discussing that before.
What?
Your parole.
Yeah, I'll be out in 2 weeks.
Don't bank on it.
Mr. Andrews will tell them.
Oh, yes, he's telling them all right. He's already made out his report. He's decided that you're a poor student, that you haven't been making the most of your opportunities, and he's recommended against your parole.
One man was killed and another critically wounded when police opened fire on a haberdashery shop in Linton Street late this afternoon. The gunman had been holding two women hostages after an attempted robbery had been earlier foiled by police. Both the hostages were unharmed.
Oh, Mrs. Morris is okay.
The search came to a climax after 24 hours when the gunman started shooting at police. A woman has been charged and remanded without bail.
Welcome back, Margo.
Magistrate's court on the 12th
of March. Oh, they're going to stop me, bro.
What? Turn the thing off. No, what was that again?
Andrew's a lousy pig. He's going to tell the prof what I've got to do me old sentence.
Where'd you hear that?
Oh, Bennett went and told me.
But he can't do that. He wouldn't.
One of better told you.
Now, shut up, Doreen. Did you say why?
Yes, I've got to learn to read and write properly before I get out.
Oh, you don't want to believe that. Old Vinegar's just having you on.
Well, one thing's for sure. If he's going to do it, there's nothing we can do to stop him.
I wouldn't bet on that.
Is that all you came in with? We better get you into a prison uniform. After the courts are finished with you, you'll probably be wearing one for quite a while. Now get behind that screen and wait for an officer.
Please let me know how Wayne's doing.
You're not entitled to ask for anything, Gaffney.
You never meant it to happen.
Mrs. Morris could have been killed because of you and your mates. Now get behind that screen before you end up in solitary.
Is Erica in?
No, she waited to hear that you were all right, then she caught the first plane to Sydney. She's got a conference with corrective services tomorrow, so I'm in the chair. If you care to wait a few minutes, I can give you a lift home.
No, Bob's waiting outside for me.
Well, then you'd better take tomorrow off. We've got a trainee. She can do some of your work.
I see how I feel.
Doing in here?
Oh, just having a cup of coffee.
You've got 15 minutes before you sign off. You should be with an officer learning your job.
Well, I tried to find you, Miss Bennett, but I didn't know what to do. I ran into B. Smith in the corridor and, well, I tried being firm, but she just laughed at me, so I decided to come back in here and wait for someone to tell me what to do.
The first thing you do is never let an inmate get the upper hand. I've already told you that. If you let them see that you're afraid or weak, you might as well forget being an officer here and now.
But it's only my first day.
I was younger than you when I first started. But I managed to put these women in their place, and on my first day. You've got to be hard on them, and you've got to mean it.
Yes, Miss Bennett.
Oh, Mick, thank heavens, you're all right. How do you feel?
Oh, I'm fine, just a bit tired.
Well, this should make you think twice about helping these women.
It wasn't really Margot's fault.
Rubbish, you're lucky you weren't killed.
You must have been terrified.
Oh, Sally Dean, Mrs. Morris.
It's Meg.
Hello. Hello. I think you're very game standing in for one of the hostages like that.
It was a stupid thing to do, Meg. You know what that sort feel about us. Has Gaffney been brought back in yet?
Look, her boyfriend got into debt gambling because he wanted a bit of extra money to pay for the rent. Now, if I'd been able to get Margot a decent job before she was released, perhaps none of this might have happened.
You're not making excuses for her.
Excuse me, I'm going home.
She's more understanding than I'd be.
She's too soft. But the women still respect her as an officer, and that's something you've got to learn.
How?
I'll show you. My way. Now, come on, come on. Who's got a cigarette for Margot? Lizzie.
Oh, we're saving these for rainy day, B.
So we've just been hit by a downpour, okay?
Yeah. Sorry to hear about your boyfriend, love.
He was only trying to win a bit, you know? Just to get us started. They sucked him in. If he didn't pay him, they would have killed him.
Why'd you have to go along with him?
Because he was always getting things screwed up.
Fat lot of good you did.
You know, I don't know what's wrong with you women. You got more brains than any guy, but you still go along with them. I mean, half of you wouldn't even be in here if it wasn't for some guy.
Yeah, once they got you, they want to keep you, you bastard.
Look out, Dracula and a baby better flapping in.
Boasting about your exploits, are you, Gaffney? On your feet when I'm talking to you. Well?
No, Miss Bennett.
Some of you women will never learn. You think the world owes you a living. At least Gaffney does. They wait until someone gets hurt, and then they blame it on everyone else but themselves.
Now, that's not always true, Miss Bennett. For instance, if someone like you got hurt, none of us would mind taking the blame.
You and your pack have already lost 2 weeks' privileges. Any more smart comments, and I'll see you lose another 2 weeks. Which reminds me, Miss Dean tells me that some of you have been insolent. If I ever hear you being rude to an officer again, you'll learn a few manners in solitary.
Blabbermouth.
And that goes for you too, Birdsworth.
Speaking of blabbermouths, Miss Bennett, what's all this about Andrew stopping George's parole?
He can object if he sees fit. He seems to think she needs educating. I think he's wasting his time.
You know, that little pipsqueak is getting just too big for his boots.
What are we going to do about it?
First thing we're going to do is we're going to boycott his classes. And then, ladies, I think it's about time we started voicing a few opinions of our own.
We'll do the same thing at breakfast. The more food we can scrounge, the longer we can hold out. And don't forget to bring whatever you've saved from your buy-up.
Yeah, okay, but we tried strikes before. They didn't work then. I don't see why they're going to work now.
That's why we're doing it outside this time. They won't be able to lock the doors on us. Doreen? Well, what's with you?
I just don't see why we're doing all this just for her, that's all.
We're not just doing this for Georgie. We're doing it for all of us. Listen, if we let someone like Andrews get away with blocking the parole board just because he thinks no one should get out of here unless they've got a degree after their name, we are all sunk.
Yeah, Doreen, we'd get out.
Put a sock in it. It's up to you, Doreen. Remember, we're doing this to beat people like Andrews and that new screw.
Yeah, well, just so long as Dumbo doesn't think it's all for her, that's all.
Flaming hell, you're both as bad as each other. Margot.
Oh, count me out. I just want to hang around inside, see if Wayne's okay, you know?
Yeah, sure, okay.
Supposing they don't let us out tomorrow morning, B?
Convince them that if we're going to be healthy in mind, we need to be healthy in body as well.
I got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way. Oh, you can't even be in a good mood around here
anymore.
Must
be the weather.
Well, it certainly wasn't the breakfast.
Yeah, I know. I've got to run off some of that porridge. I feel as though I swallowed the saucepan.
You got a point there.
It was a handle.
Oh, no, but it's a shame we can't be out in the fresh air instead of being cooped up in here.
Yeah, you're right. Hey, Mr. Fletcher, how about it? We've got 10 minutes before we have to get back to the grindstone. A bit of exercise wouldn't hurt any of us.
Every time I suggest you get a bit of exercise, you all try to find some excuse to get out of it.
Yeah, well, I was rather thinking of sport, not that back-breaking stuff you try and put us through. Do it just as much good.
And what brought this on?
It's the bikini season, Mr. Fletcher. We've got to keep in good shape.
Mm. Yeah, how else are we going to keep the body beautiful? Uh-oh, some people have no appreciation of the finer things in life.
Finer?
Oh.
Well, I suppose it wouldn't do you any harm.
Oh, thanks.
Mr. Fletcher, can I ring the hospital and see how...
We haven't got time, Gaffney. They'll let us know if there's any change.
Yeah, too busy perving on the women. You going to let her get away with that?
No, you can't afford to be too sensitive. If they know they can get at you with insults, they'll never leave you alone.
You all have such different ways of handling them.
No, don't worry. You'll find your own way soon enough.
When was this?
Same old story. I mean, she loved
the man. Yes, well, I'll see that she's told. Thank you.
Go along with him.
You're not rostered on today, Mick.
No, but give me a chance to catch up on some of my other work.
Good morning, Vera.
Morning.
Did I miss anything at the classification meeting yesterday?
I'm typing up the report now.
Oh, do I have to wait to read it?
There's nothing in it that'll affect you. Baxter's parole hearing in a few days, but that's all.
It'll help if I can get her a job before the board meets.
She won't be getting out.
There's a possibility. I mean, she's been much better behaved since the operation.
I'm recommending that she serves a full term.
And so she should, with her record of violence.
I want to see that she continues her education, and I can't if she's out of my jurisdiction. She's bright. 3 months will be the making of her.
But she's got a right to make up her own mind on that, David.
Well, I can't take that risk. She'll stand a much better chance of getting a job if she reaches a standard level of reading and writing.
You can't jeopardize her parole on those grounds.
If it's in her interests, I can, and I will.
Keeping her here in Wentworth could do her more damage. I mean, this is her first offence. She's 19 and she's mixing with some very tough women.
Well, she wasn't exactly mixing with a nice crowd outside, you know.
Has the parole officer been to see her yet?
They can't get around to see everyone.
Oh, lovely. So she's got no one advising her.
Well, I'll speak to her.
And so will I. And I warn you, David, I'm going to fight you on this one.
The board won't release her if they think that she can't cope without an education. And she can't.
She could, if I could get her a job.
Oh, Meg, if you see Gaffney, you can give her this message. I thought you'd want to tell her yourself.
Hey, we should grab a screw or something. They'd have to listen to us if we had a hostage.
Nah, just give them a reason for shooting you.
Yes, smart aleck.
This is a peaceful demonstration and there'll be no violence, understood? Now, come on, let's get a move on.
Just easy.
Hey, what are you doing with that?
Mr. Fletcher okayed it.
Crikey, Mrs. Morris, we thought we'd never see you again. We were real worried.
Come on, Doreen, we've only got 10 minutes.
Yeah, see you later, Mrs. Morris.
Now, wait outside for me, Georgie. I want to speak to you after I've seen Margo.
Now,
well, I was going to teach you how to play tennis, Mrs. Morris. Couldn't you see her later?
Oh, all right.
Wayne.
He died early this morning. I'm sorry.
The bloody pigs. They didn't have to kill him. I could have got him to give himself up.
The police didn't start shooting first, Margo.
He was scared. He'd never have hurt anyone. Not Wayne. But yous wouldn't understand. None of yous do.
Put a gun in their hands and they're nothing but a bunch of killers. Only no one locks them up because they got a badge. You can't win against the bastards no matter how much you try.
Look, maybe you should go inside and lie down for a bit.
No, I want to stay here. Make them sweat.
We're just making a point, that's all. No trouble, understood?
All right, ladies, pack it in. You heard me. Put that equipment away and get back inside. Smith, Bryant.
Stay right where you are, Fletch. We're not moving until we speak to Andrews.
What?
Get him out here. There's a few things we want to discuss with him.
What is this?
We want Andrews.
Yeah. We want Andrews!
If you've got anything to discuss, you'll discuss it with me.
We want Andrews! Stay here, keep an eye on him. You can't leave me.
Pull yourself together. They're not going to do anything. Just report to me if there's any trouble. I'll be in the staff room.
Join us for a little picnic?
Yeah, you can't have a picnic without a blowfly.
Don't speak to an officer like that. I'll put you on report.
Today I'm so tough, you scare me stiff.
Why don't you go lag to old Bennett?
Lag him!
Oh, you're as weak as water.
We want Andrews!
I want all officers on standby in case this develops into a riot. Meg, I want you to lock all the doors leading back into the prison as well as the security gates. I want this thing contained.
What about the rifles?
No, no guns. They only want to talk, for heaven's sake.
You know how these things get out of hand. They could attempt to escape anything. And we can't control a riot out in the open without some form of protection.
We'll only use them as a last resort. Do you know why they asked for you?
No idea. Unless they want me as a go-between.
Smith doesn't need a reason to cause trouble.
Well, what is it?
They're getting worse, shouting, calling me names.
Miss Dean, you were told to stay outside. A little bit of abuse won't hurt you.
If Mr. Andrews doesn't get out there soon, they're furious.
You ready? All right, let's go.
You've got no idea what it's like out there.
Come on, let's not waste a good strike. First of all, Andrews has no say in paroles, right?
Yeah, and we get back all our lost privileges.
Oh, yeah. Good one.
And tell the screws that we don't want them reading our mail anymore.
Right.
And we get chicken twice a week.
No punishment for strikes, and we can stay up all night and watch the late movies.
They must have calmed down.
Hey, B, the heavies have arrived.
Oh, that's far enough. This is between Andrews and me. We'll meet in the middle and the rest of you screws can keep back.
Is that all right with you?
Don't be ridiculous. They could take him hostage.
Hey, B, why don't you grab him now? We don't listen to us.
I'm coming over, B.
We're not going to move until we get what we want.
How'd you find out about Georgie?
Vera's got a big mouth.
I did it for her own good.
Being in here never did anybody any good.
I thought you cared for her, B.
I do. Enough to see that she and everyone else gets a fair go and they won't with you breathing down the parole board's neck.
She's not equipped to be released. She couldn't even get a job.
Well, she's not going to be any better equipped after 3 months, and I'll tell you why. If we don't get what we ask for, we're not going to go to your classes. And they'll soon figure out there's no point having a teacher if he hasn't got anyone to teach. Just think about it, Sonny.
A list of what they want.
Inside. Smith! There'll be no deals. If you go back to work now, there'll be no repercussions. But that's all.
Stick it!
Andrews will change his mind. If he wants to keep his precious job, he needs us.
When I get out of here, I'm going to build a little place by the beach and I'm going to lie in the sun all day.
Yeah, and you'll end up looking like a dried prune. Hey, Lizzie. Looks like you've got a bit of an admirer.
Want to have a good look?
Oh, Lizzie. Shame if they shut down those classes altogether, B. I mean, we've been wanting something in here like that for ages.
Look, it's Andrews we're aiming at, not the classes. They'll just have to send us a new teacher if Andrews doesn't come around to our way of thinking.
No, I think we can handle it without calling anybody in. Yes, I agree. Yes, Mrs. Davis, I'll let you know. How did they find out about your recommendation? Did you leave a report lying around or what?
No, I didn't. But now that they know, what do I do about it? Tell them that I've changed my mind?
Have you?
No.
Well, it's your decision. But even if you have changed your mind, it's a bit late now. We can't have the women think that they can make demands and get away with it on any set of precedent.
Well, they can't stay out there forever. And at least they haven't got anything to bargain with. We'll just have to wait them out.
You're all forgetting one thing. They tried a mass escape before. When they find out we aren't going to bow down to them, it could be their next move. Not to mention the destruction of prison property.
All right, we'll put an armed guard on the fence.
Can't be serious.
Only as a precaution.
I'll arrange it.
But senior officers only, please, Miss Bennett. I don't want anyone like Miss Dean getting anywhere near a rifle.
Right. Is there anything that I can do?
Yes, just stay away from the prisoners, please, Mr. Andrews. You've caused enough trouble as it is.
I think you owe me an explanation, Vera.
Oh?
Tell me why, for pity's sake, you let Smith know my stance on Georgie's parole.
I only confirmed what she already knew. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm rather...
You're lying.
All right, Mr. Andrews, I did tell Baxter. You see, I'm not like you. I don't believe in playing games with these women.
Games?
Yes, one minute you're their friend. The next you're going behind their backs.
I couldn't tell Georgie a thing like that. I can't teach her if she doesn't trust me.
Then you're a hypocrite. At least the women know where they stand with me, Mr. Andrews.
And they don't with me. Is that what you're saying?
Your job is to try giving them some sort of education, which they don't appreciate and which they'll never use.
Look, all I want is Georgie to have a decent start. Now, if that's a crime, I'm guilty of it.
Baxter should serve her full sentence because she deserves it, not because it's going to give you more time to prove you're some sort of miracle worker.
Andrew's out.
Oh, this doesn't taste too good.
No, it mustn't be mother's neither. Your Agnes bloody stuff's off. Lizzie?
I've already had mine, but I wish I hadn't. Oh.
You all right, love?
I reckon I need a drink of water.
Oh, you must be crook.
Tap's over there, love.
You all right, love? I don't think you should go brooding about everything. Why don't you just have a good cry and get it all out of your system, huh?
It was all I had, Jude.
Oh, hell.
Smith! I'll give you one last chance. Now stop this nonsense before somebody gets hurt. We're not going to give in to your demands, and that's final.
We want to speak to Andrews.
You're not going to speak to anyone.
Oh, that happened. Come on.
You're only making matters worse, Smith.
Ah. Oh, Benny!
Lizzie, what's wrong?
Oh. What do you reckon it is? Is it her heart?
No, I think it's that rotten bloody food.
Well, we've got to do something, Bill, Lizzie.
Fletch, go get Lizzie inside. She's sick.
Hey, B, let's grab him now. Give her something to fight with.
Miss Bennett!
Stand back, all of you. Now move!
Cut off the water.
What do you reckon?
Doesn't look good. About the only thing we'll get out of it is Andrews will lose his job.
Oh, that could take weeks. It's not going to help me.
Oh, shut up. At least we made ourselves heard.
No, and listen, but...
All right, Smith, you got 5 minutes. Otherwise, I call in the police. Now. Well, get back inside.
It was a stick. A lousy, bloody stick. You know, kid, you are getting too dangerous to have around. Oh, sit down and shut up.
Oh, why should I? You screwed things up, didn't you? Margaret nearly got the chop because you got no guts.
Now, you listen to me, kid. If we grab someone out there, one of us will be lying on that ground dead for real. Is it what you want? Well, is it?
Now, I've got my own way of getting back with Andrews. I'm never going to learn nothing again. Never.
The idea, which you seem to have missed, was to get Andrews to change his mind about you, not for you to change your mind about putting someone in that thick head of yours.
Oh, you're the one that said we didn't have to go to class anymore.
That doesn't mean you give up studying altogether. Oh. Now, listen to me, kid. It'll mean something to the parole board if we can prove you can learn something of your own bat. At least Andrews was right about that.
Well, I'd do nothing to scratch their back.
Anyone can teach you to read.
No, you need to.
You do, you flaming idiot. And that's what everyone will call you if you go around being ignorant for the rest of your life. And you can't bash everyone who has a go at you, Georgie, because you've got no excuse anymore. So I am going to teach you, all right? And you'll learn if I have to thump it into you.
I don't expect probationers to have the presence of mind of experienced officers, but I do expect them to show a certain amount of common sense and control.
I didn't know it was a stick, Mrs. Davidson.
You didn't know it was a knife either. You panicked. Fortunately, Miss Bennett was experienced enough to handle the situation, but you could have been responsible for a very serious accident. I realize you are under a certain amount of strain, so I'm willing to give you the benefit of the doubt. But your conduct had better improve. Is that clear?
Yes, Mrs. Davidson.
I want to see all those involved in the strike in the recreation room, Miss Bennett. And would you let Mr. Andrews know that I want to see him?
There is one more thing, Mrs. Davidson. Miss Dean claims Smith threatened her.
Oh? What did she say?
Well, it was more the way she said it. She said I was too dangerous to have around.
Yes, well, under the circumstances, I can hardly blame her. You'd better make sure you remain with an officer at all times. Just to be on the safe side. Thank you, Miss Bennett. Mr. Fletcher was acting governor in my absence. You should have taken any worries you had directly to him instead of resorting to such a stupid and dangerous course of action.
Would it have made any difference?
The matter could have been discussed in a civilized manner. All you have achieved is having Baxter's name included in a report I am sending to the department. As for the other matters you raised, the department makes the rules, not the inmates.
You're all going to make up for the work you missed today. There'll be no recreation. You'll stay in the laundry until it's time to go to your cells.
You mean we miss out on tea?
There'll be a half-hour break. Now move.
Will Lizzie be okay?
As far as I know. Now hurry up.
Oh. Well, you can't expect Margo to go back to work. I mean, they've given her something to calm her down. She's zonked.
She can stay in her cell.
Come on.
Baxter's behavior would have to improve drastically for me to recommend her parole. So the board will not be just acting on your recommendation.
The women don't see it that way.
Well, they should never have found out about it.
Yes, well, whatever I decide is going to be the wrong move. If I change my mind, the women will think they blackmailed me into it. That means I'm weak, I've lost their respect immediately. If I stand my ground, no one comes to my class, and you don't need a teacher anymore. At least not me.
Unfortunately, I can't force them to go back. I don't know how, but you'll have to gain their trust all over again.
After her, to or a good hurt.
Tough.
Tough? Mm. Yeah, well, you could spell it T-U-F-F if you're too D-U-M-B to understand.
Doreen, why don't you P-I-S-S off?
After her...
Hope Margo's gonna be okay.
Yeah, well, it's lucky for her Vera's a bad shot, isn't it?
What?
You don't think she was aiming to miss, do you?
Yeah.
Will you two keep it down?
Jail. You're locked up in one, in case you hadn't noticed.
Oh, shut up!
Look, I won't warn you again, Doreen.
Well, you're gonna have to face it, B. She's gonna have to do better than that if she's gonna impress the parole board.
All she has to do is prove to them that she's working at it.
Yeah. Well, why don't we help her along a little bit? You know, pull a swifty.
I'm listening.
What if Georgie gives Andrews and Dave a reading lesson?
Then she'd never get out.
No, I mean she's good, you know, real good. Proves she doesn't need Andrews. I think I know a way we can do it.
Oh, hey, Margo, how's it going? Oh, we heard Vera took a pot shot at you. Is it true?
I'll kill her one day. She nabbed me $500 I had from running the book.
Oh, yeah. Well, Judy got into real strife trying to smuggle it out to you, you know.
We needed that money. Wayne wouldn't have started gambling, getting in deep. He'd still be alive.
Yeah. Well, I was surprised you went on strike to help Georgie.
What's she got to do with it?
Oh, she's how come Vera found out we was trying to smuggle a 500 out to you. Well, you mean you didn't know? Yeah, she told Vera all about it.
Trapp, what do you think you're doing here?
Oh, good day, Miss Bennett. I was just saying who you'd locked up.
I'll let you handle this, Miss Dean. It's about time you took a bit of responsibility on your shoulders. Don't worry, you won't have any trouble with her. And the others are locked in the laundry.
Trapp,
Trapp, is it?
You can call me Mouse if you like.
Aren't you supposed to be in the recreation room?
Oh, I must have taken a wrong turn. Oh, I'm only new in here, see? Like you.
Don't talk rubbish. She's been in and out of here since she was 17.
Any more games like that, and I'll have you scrubbing the floors.
Yes, miss.
Go on, off you go. I'm not a fool, Trapp. You'd better remember that.
Yes, Miss D.
And you can tell your friends that I'm not the sort of officer who puts up with any nonsense.
Yes, Miss D.
If any of you step out of line just once, well, you'll find out how hard I can be.
Yes, Miss D.
Oh, and I expect the same sort of respect that you show Miss Bennett.
Oh, yes, Miss Dean.
After her tough husband Tom has gone to jail.
After her tough husband Tom has gone to jail.
Joy finds perfect love in the arms of Jim.
Joy finds perfect love in the arms of
She's
Jim.
She's never going to remember all that.
She'll do it. Now listen, if you do get past Andrews, you've got to promise me you're going to keep on studying, okay?
Yeah, sure.
Well, listen to me. You don't want to do too good a job, either. You've got to make it sound real. Stumble over a few words now and then, okay? Otherwise, Andrews will be on to you.
Oh, good, I caught you. The women are planning to make a fool of Mr. Andrews. Should I tell Mrs. Davidson?
What?
Well, they're making that Baxter girl learn passages out of a book. They want to prove that she can learn to read without Mr. Andrews.
And I suppose one of the women told you?
No, they didn't know I was listening. They couldn't see me. I was going to tackle them about it, but I thought I should tell Mrs. Davidson first.
That was a good move.
Is she still here?
I think we'll let them have their fun first. I'll tell Mrs. Davidson when the time's right.
Oh, but...
Go on.
Well, it's just that she doesn't think very much of me at the moment.
She knows you're responsible. You're learning, Miss Dean. Nice work. Not enough sleep, Smith. Or was working late too much of a shock to the system?
Yeah, shock to the system around here is you, Vera.
Burns, will you get that muck off your nose?
Oh, well, you see, I got windburnt yesterday, Miss Bennett, and I thought I might have to go and see the sister about it.
It's just an excuse to visit Birdsworth, and it won't work. Now, hurry up.
Bennett, I've got to see Mr. Andrews and Mrs. Davidson. I've got something to show them, but I've got to show them in the rec room.
If they see you, it'll be where Mrs. Davidson wants it to be. We're not at your beck and call, Baxter.
No, I can't show him anywhere else. It's got to be there.
I'll let you know.
Give that back!
God, it's really you take this up.
Will you stop this at once? Don't you think that you two have been in enough trouble?
Yeah, well, she
second
started.
Shelf down. Third from the right. Last bookcase.
You don't get second down, third right.
Last bookcase. Don't you forget it. No. Don't you forget it either.
Well, I'll just pick anyone. I've been practicing on my own ever since Mr. Andrews started teaching me. I reckon I can do it by myself now.
Get on with it, Baxter. We haven't got all day.
After her tough husband, Tom, has gone to jail, Joy finds perfect love in the arms of Jim. Till Jim gets 12 years for robbery with violence. She still loves him, but her restless, impulsive nature drives her to snatch sex and excitement wherever she can find them, working as a barmaid, taking up modelling, and always moving from man to man to man.
Well, I must say I'm impressed.
Just a minute, Mr. Andrews. I'd like Baxter to read something else for us. Well, go on, Baxter. Show us how you can really read.
No, I've done me bit. She's got in for me. It's not fair.
She won't read because she can't. That passage was memorized. She was stupid enough to think we'd fall for it.
Why, Georgie? Don't you understand what an education can do for you?
Yeah, make me into a two-faced liar like you.
One more insolent remark like that and you'll spend 24 hours in solitary, Baxter.
Do you honestly think I'd do anything to hurt you? I've been trying to help you.
Oh, but keep me locked up in here?
If it'll ensure that you never end up back inside, yes.
Well, I made it before I could do it on my own.
Mr. Andrews is a very good teacher who's concerned about your future. He's also responsible for your getting your hearing back.
Yeah, well, maybe I don't like what I hear. If anyone's going to teach me, it's not going to be him.
You've really done it this time, Baxter. I'd say Mrs. Davidson's report to the parole board is going to be very interesting.
Don't you worry, we'll get Andrews. He'll be chucked out, then we'll see he's laughing.
At least he now knows he's been wasting his time on types like you.
I don't want any more pills. They're keeping me drugged. I've got to keep my wits about me.
Your sister only wants to see how you are. You won't have to take them.
Yeah, and you'd know, wouldn't you? They'd try anything in this joint to keep you quiet.
Lager! You killed Wayne! Bloody!
Get Baxter to the laundry and make sure you lock the gate.
Oh, slam off me, creep! You'd have been a padded cell!
I'll kill her!
That 500 bucks would have got us out of hock. You're all in it, weren't you? None of yous wanted to see us make it.
That's not true, Margot. The money was confiscated because you made it through illegitimate means.
Got a job. It was too late. He was going to set me up in real style. We were going to get married, have lots of kids, a home.
I think Margot had better be moved to A Division, Miss Bennett.
Don't know what he saw in me, really. Could have had anyone. But he never... He wanted me.
Bennett knew what he was up to all along.
You're joking, how?
Well, how would I know? Some mongrel must have lagged.
Mouse, had to be. She's anyone outside this room that could have done it.
For your information, it was me.
Pull the other one.
You'd have let Margo kill me if it was up to you, you weak-kneed freak. How dare you speak to me like...
What's this about Margo?
Oh, she's off a rocker. She called me a lag and reckon I killed her boyfriend.
Damn.
You're not as smart as you all think you are, you know.
Now, where have I heard that line before?
I think she's been listening to vinegar too much.
Yeah, I reckon we ought to call her vinaigrette.
Go ahead, but don't underestimate me. Stumble over a few words, otherwise Andrews will be on to you. Isn't that what you said?
How'd you know that?
I overheard you talking. You'd all better be a bit more careful of me in the future. And get on with your work.
Bitch!
You know, she's more stupid than I thought she was.
She scares me too. I mean, almost getting Margot shot. We got to get rid of her, B.
Oh, she's so keen on eavesdropping. Maybe we should give her something she can really listen to.
Well, what good will that do?
Notice how quick she was to take the credit for dobbing us in.
Yeah, Vera must have taken the credit all by herself.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, she never said nothing about Gutless having a hand in it.
Well, I think I can think of a way to get under Andrew's skin and teach little Miss Uppity that it's about time she played by our rules.
Settle down. A band-aid will fix that.
Oh, it might be small, but it's deep.
All right, well, you can go and see the sister.
I think I'm going to faint.
No, you're not.
I don't think I'm going to make it on my own. I'll bleed to death.
Don't panic. I'll see that you get there.
How much longer is this going on for, Vera? You know, it's getting a bit much having to go to the loo in groups.
The gate will be open soon enough, but don't get too excited. We'll be watching you very carefully from now on.
Hallelujah.
Miss Bennett.
What is it now?
Well, it's about Margot. We were a bit worried about her. We thought she mightn't be feeling too well.
She's been Bennett patted you on the back yet, Miss Dean, or isn't she sharing the limelight with you?
Will she be okay?
Of course she'll be all right.
Hey, B, I've got to get to the library.
I'm not going to classes anymore, remember?
Yeah, well, I left something in and I've got to get it back.
What are you talking about?
Oh, when Mike came to visit me, he slipped me some stuff.
You mean you planted it in the library?
Yeah, I made a false bot in one of them pottery things, and I stashed it there.
What of all the nongs? How are we going to get it back if we're not going to Andrew's classes?
Oh, forget about it. It'll be safe enough. All we have to do is wait until Andrews isn't there.
Look, Burns, can you stop asking stupid questions and get into work?
Excuse me, Miss Bennett. I've got to go somewhere. It's important.
Oh, all right.